Okay, call the meeting to order. All members are present and accounted for. If everyone would please stand, face the flag if you will. Do you recite the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Jerry said the pledge twice today.
Yeah.
He's here, honey.
Okay. Any additions, changes to the agenda at all?
Yeah, I'd like to make some additions if the board will approve it. I started with two items and it ended up apparently being four. One is the donations. Actually, let's go with three. I'm going to skip number two. One is integrity of schedule C, and the last one is staff development funds. Do you want to add those to this meeting or the next?
Mentioned again, are these the consent agenda items?
Well, they're kind of related to them, but they're not directly on them. So, I mean, I don't know if you want to throw them in there, or if the it's discussion more than anything for these things.
What are they again?
Donations, integrity of schedule C, and staff development funds.
The donations are part of the consent agenda.
Right, it is. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's discussion, yeah. I guess.
Okay. You know, let's put them on the next agenda for a full-blown conversation. You okay with that?
Yep. I'll give you the sheet so you can remember.
I can have
them. Yep. Okay, and so actually we're having no agenda changes here. So I would look for a motion to approve the agenda as shown.
I'll make a motion.
Motion by Rob, seconded by Jerry. Other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That is carried. Schedule presenters, Dave Peterson, facility update and review of 16 summer project. Mr. Peterson.
Just to give you a quick snapshot of where we're at right now, I think I'll start out at the high school. The high school boilers are now fully functional and on both natural gas and fuel oil. The controls, NAC continues to work on the controls installation and the ventilation project recommissioning. The existing, for what we had done, and also the existing field house wing controls. So we're looking pretty good here at the high school. Things are coming along nicely in the last week. A lot of controls work was done, so with that being done, the commissioning can go forward. Elementary school, Minnesota Energy replaced the gas meter orifice last Wednesday, and Ryan Mechanical fixed the gas piping error in the mechanical penthouse. The boilers are now fully functional as of last Friday. Minnesota Energy is still planning to replace the entire gas meter, and UNESCO is coordinating this with them. Length of outage for the meter replacement is unknown at this time, so I don't know if they'll wait till the summer because winter coming up or what they're going to do. If it's a couple hours, maybe they'll do it this winter. It's, you know, we'll have to get that information from Minnesota Energy. The problem we had was with the new boilers, we had new pressures we needed for the gas. Had to work with Minnesota Energy to get the right orifice in the meter to get us functioning. They would work on low, but when they kicked on high, we would lose pressure and they would go into failure. So that was repaired last week. The controls, NAC is close to to complete their work and has told UNESCO that they're far enough along to allow for the commissioning. Balancing work is very close to complete with a few minor repairs required before it can be finished. Should happen this week, so we should be really good by the end of this week. There is some Dolish Associates was on site last week completing the final inspections at both schools. We'll have final punch list early this week. Commissioning, they will start the commissioning at the elementary school this week also, now that the controls, and of course now that the gas is working. So that was kind of the holdup at the elementary. November 1st and 2nd, this is at the community center. November 1st and 2nd will be the installation of the steel columns and the duct penetrations for the North Gym unit. The ship date is Friday the 4th on the rooftop equipment. So the goal is to have equipment set on the roof before the weekend. Electrical main service has been installed and the majority of the electrical heat has been installed. NAC is going to get over there later this week to start the interfacing with the equipment over there. So all the roofing is done over there, and we're going to start placing some equipment on the roof. That's really it. Any questions?
No leaks in the elementary, the old elementary then anymore.
Not in the gym, no, oh. No.
It's not in the gym was your qualifying statement.
Yes. Well, we really didn't have any leaks in any other parts of the building, to be honest with you. So, no, the leaks, the major leaks and the problems that we had have been addressed and fixed. So, you just really in time for cold, freezing weather, you know.
You really were proud that you were staying on budget and staying on task all summer.
Correct.
If you could look back now, is there anything that's nagging at you as the head maintenance?
No, not really. I think it went pretty well. I'm pretty happy with where we're at right now. Normal construction kind of headaches that pop up. I mean, nothing that really was extremely out of the ordinary. Everything stayed within budget to this point. And the reason I say this point is we're not done yet, you know. But no, I'm pretty happy with the way things went. You know, I know a lot of people don't notice this, but a lot of work was done in a short amount of time. And it's all in the bones of, you know, the structure of the school, the boilers, the rooftop units. A lot of work was done. I don't think anyone realizes how much work was done to the buildings of this district. I'm actually pretty proud of everybody. We had a good group of contractors. Everyone worked hard. I'm very happy.
Sometimes the subcontractors are the kind of the nightmare for a lot of generals and
you bet.
Folks like you. You found them to be, we're not having issues like we did in our building project, as far
no,
as you're aware?
No. I'm very happy. I got to work, you know, I'm really in the trenches with these guys every day, so I get to see exactly what's going on, and I'm very pleased with the subcontractors that we had in here and with the way things went. I would, at this point, I can say I'm extremely pleased. I've had it a lot worse. So, yeah, I'm very happy, and things are coming along, and Mother Nature's really agreed with us. I'll be honest with you. We've gotten lucky, but I'll take that. I'll take a little bit of luck.
One of the things I noticed is I think this equalization aid, and Jerry knows this as well, it's going to disappear. We really hit the timing just perfectly to do a project like this. I think some of the people that didn't do it are kind of kicking themselves. They thought that money might come again and come again. And the districts that moved ahead with this energy savings and some of these things, would you agree, we just hit the time slot perfectly?
I think another thing with luck, we were three quarters into the project when this became available to us, and that's why most districts missed this opportunity, almost by design, so no one would use it, you know?
Right.
But we were able to capitalize on it and take advantage of it, and it was a huge benefit for this district. We have some really good permanent solutions in place and operating at this point, and I'm very happy with that for long term. So yeah, timing was a big part of this.
Any other questions for Dave? Thank you.
Thank you.
Reports and communication. We have no student reps here today, so committee reports. Anyone have anything for the cause on committees?
Curriculum is meeting on November 28th. Finance is meeting on November
4th.
Is that right?
Sounds right. Kirk, you remember it?
Yeah, it's in the morning, like 10, isn't it?
It's okay. It looked like one of you could make it, so we went ahead with that. Facility, Dave, I know did he already leave? Mm-hmm. We sent that out as well. We'll be working on facilities after mosquito cells, looking at some priority lists. So.
Okay.
We met last week. Kirk's chairing that now. Really, the main talk was talking about Aaron and first contract review. So we're putting that together. Just starting to get that rolled up. The superintendents are working with that.
I need to still do his evaluation too.
Yeah.
Anyone else?
Okay, moving on. Public input. Anyone wishing to speak to the board about school-related items? This is your chance right now. Individual complaints will be handled privately through the administrators. Comments from visitors should be informational, and you can read all the rest. Does anyone have anything that they would like to discuss with the board at this time? Moving on. Consideration to approve the finance report. Mr. Mr. Davis?
Yeah, page 3 in the packet there. And again, just another short and brief one, and our auditor will be in our office next week. Just some of the highlights on the top, you'll see the bank account balances, the first one being Merchants Bank, our cash on hand for day-to-day operations and payroll. And then the TD Ameritrades are the two bonds proceeds for the building project. One thing to note, as Dave mentioned a lot, being on budget and on time with things, having filled a bunch of bond updates for a lot of the subcontractors, a majority of the contracts for the high school and elementary are the 95%. We're holding the 5% retainage as commissioning is completed and UNESCO is, and Dave are signing off on they're okay to release the final funds. So CCC, we still have a ways to go as they've just started that project at school, started here. So just kind of a little more financial update on the project. As far as cash flow goes, you can see a healthy balance when you take out the bond proceeds, not having to do any anticipation borrowing, which is a good position for the district to be in. IDEAS payments, as we talked about, are back to the 90-10 as they have been for a while now, as well as the referendum being in place has helped out with that. So if you have any questions, I do my best to answer whatever you may have, and I look forward to being more complete with financial reports as the audit is completed.
I know that Bob and Kurt are aware because they're on the finance committee, but we'll be looking at some refunding. We'll bring Jeff Seeley in to present all of that to the entire board. But just know that conversation is coming because rates have just gotten really, really good again. And it's their advisement to at least look at it.
Yeah, we've come into a time to the time factor as well. In the past, it hasn't been beneficial to us, and now it may be where we can see some savings either in terms of interest and or timeline of paying off the debt. Mm-hmm.
Refunding and refinancing mean just the same thing, right?
Pretty much.
All right.
Refunding is usually used when you're talking bonds and things like that. But
I'll make a motion to approve.
Second.
Motion by Jerry, seconded by Kurt. Other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That is carried. Consent agenda. Items under the consent agenda are considered routine and will be enacted under one motion. In the event that the board member wants to discuss any one item, it will be removed from the consent agenda for separate action. I would like to discuss individually item D, approval for the resolution of the acceptance of gifts, for further discussion.
If there's a correction on the minutes, do you have to pull it out or not?
I was going to say that.
You weren't at the last meeting.
Right.
That's
me as president.
Did I jump?
No, she's just saying he wants to pull that off, too.
Well, do we need to pull it off to make the change?
You should, technically.
Okay, so pull up item A.
That's okay. You can approve everything else.
We
just make that correction.
So we so rarely do this. Do we approve what we have and then discuss the balance, or do we discuss?
We can.
Either way?
Actually, I already consent agenda policy the day by chance, and just remove them and continue on like normal, and then take action on the ones that you removed.
That's what I was just saying. Yeah.
Okay. So what are you telling me then? If we remove these for discussion, then when should discussion take place?
After you vote on the first ones that are still left behind,
so
that
you
left
say,
out.
Except for A and D.
Yes. Then we'll discuss A and D.
So then I'll make a motion to approve the consent agenda with the exception of D.
A and D.
Motion by Kurt.
I'll second the motion.
Seconded by Rob. Further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? We are carried, 5-0. Consent agenda, item A.
Correction to the October 10th minutes.
The October 10th minutes should be reconciled to exclude
that
Brenda.
I was absent. Brenda was absent.
To exclude Brenda due to her absence.
No, it's unusual. But
we're not asking to qualify things here. I'm asking.
Okay.
That would be our only change. All in favor of the amendment to the minutes of the 26th and 10th, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Okay.
approval of a resolution of acceptance of gifts. I think in particular from my perspective, and maybe mine alone, the $2,300 donation from the dance team seemed to have drawn some, at least conversation among board, some board members. And first of all, I don't know what resolution came from that. I know Rob had some concerns with regard to how, if we were doing the appropriate thing with the monies. Did we, was there an ultimate outcome for that?
We did. We worked on that item, got some advice from outside and inside, and, you know, checked things. I think what we're going to do is go ahead and add another column so that we know that we're accepting the donation of $2,300. And then this is already being done, so it's not a big thing. Jake then documents what it's being spent on and what it's being designed for. So we will now accept the donation, and we will accept what it's being used for. So a good example is if they do $6,000 for uniforms and they only spend $5,900, obviously that $100 would go back to the dance committee because they didn't spend it on exactly uniforms. And so Jake has already been doing this, so this is a really easy thing to do. We'll add that. And that way we're all the way around, we're not only approving the dollars, but we're also approving the what. It's hard. We're so grateful for what these groups do for us. We just want to accept their funds and be grateful. Sometimes it gets hard to say, well, what are you going to use it for? You know, those types of things are hard questions because we're just so grateful to get those funds. But after kind of researching this, we should list the what, and so we will go ahead and do that.
So in something like that, Beth, when you say, like, say it's you donate $2,000 or $1,500,
mm-hmm.
can you just go back to the Booster Club?
Or is it, say it again.
Well, let's say it's $2,000 that they donate and they want it for uniforms,
mm-hmm.
and then it only costs $1,500. Can that extra $500, does that have to be designated still for?
It has to go back to them, and then they can choose what. Like exactly how Lori's got it listed in here, $2,300 from the Bomber Dance for coaches' salaries.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and we're designating exactly what it's for.
Right. So basically, would there ever be any extra amount?
There could be, but Jake works with them, don't you, Jake,
yeah.
ahead of time yeah. to get that amount set. Then what he does is he goes to, and I believe this year it's Ms. Larson, in
yeah.
charge of the Bomber, the dance booster
yeah.
club, and he'll say, okay, this is what we're going to need for salaries. You know, so they try to
yeah.
match it up.
I'm just wondering if there's more there than you need, if it could go back to the booster club and then you could use it for something else.
Oh, it absolutely has to. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I just didn't think
yeah.
you wait until 2 years from now when they need another,
mm-hmm.
then it goes for outfits if it's been designated for that. Okay.
There was, during this back and forth, there was some discussion about Schedule C and how it plays into increasing maybe a varsity wage or something that would dispute what we do with Schedule C.
Yeah, that question was raised too. So the money donated tonight was for coaches' salaries, and we pay according to Schedule C. We're not paying anybody above Schedule C. There are some of those salaries that are not on Schedule C, but from what we have found out, that's okay as long as we're not paying above what our Schedule C says for a coaching position.
Okay. I guess my other question would be that when we get our agendas on a Wednesday, I think the idea behind the agenda is to say to the board, here's what we have, and if there's anything you have some questions about, let us know. But more than that, just here's your agenda. And there was talk about this before our agenda even, well, as soon as it became known. And the number of emails and what I feel like is stepping over the boundaries of what our job is supposed to be on board is very concerning to me. I feel like there was probably 7 or 8 or 9 emails that occurred back and forth between Rob and the rest of the staff that I think that should have been done and taken care of this evening.
I don't think there was anything on those emails that couldn't have waited till tonight. And I just wonder, you know, where the directive came for you to get so involved with those things. That would be my question.
My involvement is my question of what I saw on the agenda. I believe we get it on Wednesday to review to know what's coming up. And I've had situations, irrigation system, where I saw it on the agenda and asked no questions till we got to the meeting to truly find out what it was. Well, it was really too late at that point to, I didn't have the opportunity to go out and see the location of the irrigation system or anything where obviously other board members had. So those questions must have been asked beforehand so you guys knew what it was about. So I felt I was left in the dark on that one particularly. It kind of rubbed me the wrong way going, I should have asked earlier. I should have shot the emails out to go tell me more. I thought it was a replacement for a broken system because it was April, we turned the new system on, and it broke. So when I saw the agenda come out, I asked a simple question because I had a conversation with MSBA about a year ago that said, when an employee gets paid by the district, if it's not on a contract, it gets approved by the board. So that was my premise to ask the question. If a donation, which before this year we didn't know what donations we were getting, because it just came up last year, I asked. So with the donation, not just do we accept the funds, but then do we also need to, for procedure purposes, not for I don't want to pay someone, but I like to be correct in the procedure of the process. Do we need to approve the person getting the funds as well? And that was my question. And that snowballed into other questions that Beth had. Now, I also asked, because people are going to go, well, gosh, why are you picking on boosters? I'm not picking on anybody. It happened to be on the agenda that the boosters were donating money to the coaches. I don't remember ever seeing donation from boosters to a coach. So it raised my question. I could ask here tonight, but at the same point, then maybe the answer may have delayed the vote. I don't know. So I thought if we're proactive, we can be proactive tonight, depending on the answer or the question. I figured it was a fairly simple question. But then I asked about staff development because at times they may get money as well through their own budget. So I asked Beth that specific question because they get stipends and we've seen stipends cross our desk here. So I asked that question. And the back and forth, really, I think more than anything, would be clarification of the question I'm asking, because I'm probably not asking it in enough detail. So there might be clarification needed. I talked to Beth tonight about that, and we're pretty clear. I asked her if I'm asking too many questions. She goes, no, but if you ask a question, please bring it to the next agenda meeting. So that's why I was asking to have those items put on the agenda, was stemming from these questions. But
and
it's not.
And my reason for that is I really do want everyone to hear everything. You know, it isn't ever my intent. I mean, I feel like part of my job is to answer all of your questions. And randomly, you had a great one today. It was when did we get rid of C-Squad coaches? Those kinds of things. Those are quick, easy questions we can answer, but we want to make sure we bring that in so everyone has the answer.
So I never give a directive. I don't feel as a single board member I can give a directive. The directives come from this table when we're all here and in session. But I feel that as a board member, I can ask questions, whether it's on the agenda or not, regarding our school district, which is what I felt I did. Now, I did talk to MSBA about that particular subject alone. And MSBA said, well, if you don't want anybody to ask any questions to the administration outside of the meeting, then add it to your policy. He goes, there is not a policy right now regarding that. So our conduct is, you can kind of do what you want. But then anything, your question about C varsity coaches should not be asked to administration. Irrigation should not have been asked. My question shouldn't be asked. So all those questions would have to be tabled to the meeting, which I know sometimes people like to get out of these meetings earlier fast. I just asked a simple question for my own knowledge, not for a directive for the board or for everyone to know. I figured if you have a question, you'll ask, just like the C-Squad coaches. I don't know enough to ask. I wasn't concerned with that, so I didn't ask. You did. Did you want that answer for the entire board or just for your curiosity?
Just some of my curiosity.
And that's how I ask my questions, for my curiosity. And I apologize.
The difference is, and I'll just say, you have a lot of questions, and they're good questions. It's just, I think it's the concern a little bit of that time. So if we could add it to the agenda, it becomes an agenda item, and then we can work on the agenda. So I like what you did tonight. Give Bob those questions. I think that's a good way to do it.
And I'm not saying they need to be answered by the next meeting or by the meeting or that you even have to answer them. I'm just asking a question. If you come back and say, we're putting them on the next agenda because this one's already set, it's going to be addressed. That's wonderful. I've never given a time frame, I don't think, on any question I've asked. I know you.
One other request I have, and I really am taking this personally. When people are approaching you and you refuse to give me the name of the person that's giving you the information, that makes it really hard for me to do my job. And I express that to you.
Mm-hmm.
We need to stop saying, this person told me this. Can you check out if it's correct or not? That person needs to talk to me. I just really need the secrecy to stop because it puts me in a tough spot. Who are these people that continue to go to you that feel uncomfortable coming to me? One of my main goals that you guys have for me is, do I have an open door? Am I, you know, do people feel comfortable coming to me? And recently we've had a lot of that where someone, and we spoke about that, you know, I don't like that. It's just really important to me that if someone comes to you and has a concern, I don't necessarily need to know who they are, but you need to encourage them to come talk to me. That would really help me understand the true dilemma.
And in this situation we talked, it wasn't that someone approached me, it was a kind of almost a side comment of, that could become a Title IX issue.
Yeah, but your words were, our district could get sued. You know,
that was the fault. If it's a Title IX, could one coach say, hey, someone else is getting paid more than me, we got a Title IX issue. It wasn't that they are saying that our district, they weren't addressing it towards anyone. It was just one coach is being this way, a coach could be this way, and all of a sudden, Title IX is being mentioned. And that's what it was, as a mention.
Yeah.
Still, my issue is when you ask these questions, there was nothing in any of your emails that couldn't have been directed tonight. If you ask a staff member to go to MSBA to clarify a situation, shouldn't that be best done in here with us? It wasn't a life-threatening thing. It wasn't anything other than information that you needed to get. And first, the question has to do with the dance team, relative boosters, that thing. Then it goes into who our new assistant coaches may be. Then it goes into staff development. And finally, it goes in one other direction I can't remember. A total of 9 emails. I think that some of that should belong with us. And again, it has been your history to at least want to get more information for the meeting.
Yeah.
And I feel that's fair to a certain point, but Kurt and I had an animated conversation about 3 weeks ago about my statement about inefficiency. And it was resentful to him, if I can paraphrase, and I understand that. But we've never had situations that, during the course of that 9 emails, if you kind of look at where that goes, and maybe a subsequent, did you meet on this morning?
We did as an admin group.
A staff development type of conversation. Mm-hmm. If I would bank all those hours up that seem to be taken away from our staff, that's what I call inefficient. And it's not been done one time, it's been done several times. And so I stand by my inefficiency statement only because we could be loading up 5 or 6, 10 hours of total staff time that I don't think is well suited for us as a board. They bring their issues into us, and we respond to them. You know, I guess technically, me or Jerry and I should be finalizing the agenda, and we don't always get to it. We look for the staff to tell us what's the most important thing we got today to deal with. Is it the sequential hiring of staff? Is it financial issues? Did we have a major breakdown of some kind? That's the way that the things always seem to go. And if we have an issue like staff development, that should be taken and
compartmentalized in its own area when the time is right. It just seems to get pulled out for conversation. And however you think you did as far as the conversation asking about the MSBA, I believe it was more of a directive. And I don't think that's correct. I don't think that's the way to go about it. And you're a guy steeped in procedure and policy, but sometimes, to me, you violated policy here. You violated what we are doing. And we can talk all day about it.
I'm going to disagree with what you're saying, Bob. I commend you for doing it, Rob. I think you had a question. I know about 3 weeks ago, I was told not to call the MSBA because it's undermining administration. I didn't think so. I thought it was information gathering to prepare for a meeting or to because of this request. And now, from what I gather, Rob had a question before coming to the meeting. He requested that the administration call the MSBA, and now they're saying don't call the MSBA because it's conflicting with time and scheduling restraints. We're still just trying to do our job. We're trying to gather information. We're trying to get all the information we have that we can get going to a meeting so we're prepared. Like Rob said that one time with the irrigation, I knew nothing about it, but some people did. And then so that didn't seem to be an issue. I think what's happening sometimes is once that information is requested, then things kind of maybe, we do too much research than we need to before it gets to the meeting. From what I saw in some of the conversations with email, it's like there's simple requests and all of a sudden got information from this person, information from this person. It's like, that's where it could stop. It's like, just get information from the MSBA, let's bring it to the meetings, wherever you find. But I don't want to think that we can't call MSBA and that you can't call the MSBA. Nobody knows everything about everything. We're just doing our job. We need to be allowed to do our job. Things happen, there's questions we have outside the board meeting. Now, if that's the case, then Bob, you shouldn't have any contact with the administration until the next meeting. None of us should. If that's the way it is, then that's the way it can be. I'm totally fine with that. Let's do it that way, but it's got to be consistent.
Might have some long meetings. And I'll piggyback on that. Yes. I was chastised in the newspaper and at the meeting for going to MSBA with everything, undermining administration. And I said, no, it's so I don't bother administration. So the next time I have a question, which is 2 meetings later, I go to the administration. Now I'm wasting their time. So my question is, would you like me to go to the MSBA with questions? Or to the administration with questions, or talking with MSBA today, because I did do that as well, I wasted their time. If you guys want to make this a policy, we can. It's got to be unanimous. It's got to be a board vote, first and second motion, that we don't talk to the administration before meetings, period. And it has been a policy. It would be a policy change. Otherwise, there is no policy that states how we, as board members, can interact with the staff or the administration. So that means all your questions that you have, as simple as they are, have to wait for the meeting. We can't preempt either because we're asking the questions. But I'm not trying to take up anyone's time here. I'm just trying to get a simple, what I thought would be a fairly simple answer. And I apologize that it wasn't as simple as I thought it was. And sometimes I think my simple question becomes more of a major question for you. And I think if you'll read on one of my first few emails, it just said, just asking. To me, just asking is not the directive. I'm just asking to get clarification.
When you asked me tonight, that's what I said. It would be nice to get that really good information that you find out to the whole board. So I like when you just brought this in and said, can we add this to the next agenda? I think that's a really good way to do it. Because instead of asking the exact question, say, would you mind adding this to the agenda? We approve that on a Tuesday afternoon, typically, Lori. We send it over to Bob. Sometimes Wednesday, if you don't get it till Thursday, it's because we're crazy busy and we look over it on Wednesday, we do the final thing. I think that's a good way to do it because then I don't have to feel bad that I haven't given you all the same information.
I think also what we need to understand is the MSBA is not, they don't set statute, they don't make laws, they're an advisory board. They're an advisory board that we as a district pay into to do just these things, to call them up. If we have questions as a board member, give them a call. It's not to undermine anybody. It's not to undermine the administration. It's to answer questions that any question that we have that has anything to do with monies in the district, spending monies,
policies, procedures, anything, we can use it at any time. And so I don't want to, as a board member, feel that we can't do these things, because we can. It's perfectly legitimate, and it's our right.
One of the things that we're supposed to prepare for every meeting, that is actually in what we're supposed to do. And did I ask Jake about what your assistant coaches? I did. Why? Jake might not be here at the meeting. He sometimes has other commitments at a meeting. So I would like to know before the meeting who the change-up is. That was a simple question. I didn't think that it necessarily had to come tonight, because if Jake wasn't here, I could ask, but no one would be here to answer.
You're presupposing that Jake won't be here, so I'm going to ask that question in advance. I still hang my hat on the inefficiency when we ask multiple questions. If you would have left it at the Bomber dance team, I have questions, that's one thing. But it kept going throughout the day and most of the other day. You and I have spoke before about the propriety of emails, and and both of us probably fall down at some point in time. But I don't feel like anything that was asked there, you're saying I'm just doing some preemptive work, but in your capacity as a board member, when you ask questions, it isn't perceived like every taxpayer out in the community. It's Bob's asking a question, Jerry's asking a question, Rob is asking a question. We better get them answers. When in fact, that's not who we're supposed to be. And I don't believe the MSBA is always just your first stop. I believe that sometimes we second guess what our admin is saying, and then we go to MSBA. And the second thing would be, is there is a policy out there that says the board chairman is basically the conduit between the board and the superintendent. And whatever kind of motions you want to make, that is part of the policy, and it ends up saying, and plus the board chair, not only does he run the meeting, but he's also the person that has contact with the board or with the superintendent. And I'll hang my hat on that is the reason. I don't seek them out. I don't need this information before the board meeting. And I do say that there has been monies that were spent in this situation and other situation because we seem to want a right to know. And if it is indeed advisory, maybe you need their advice. I think I can figure most of this stuff out all by my lonesome here.
You've been here 20 years, Bob. I've been here six. So, again, as a board member, I have the right to, I guess, ask a question. Your belief is wrong. I haven't gone to the administration and then to MSBA. I've gone to the MSBA and then at times have gone to the administration to advise them, forwarding the email, what MSBA has told me. So that's what I've done. So again, am I looking to waste a lot of the admin's time? No. But I have come to meetings and I felt that I've been steamrolled over being unprepared for meetings. So I don't like that feeling. I don't like coming in here finding out that something in the agenda is completely something else. I don't feel that I've done my job to prepare for the meeting. So if you're saying that I can't prepare for a meeting, and I do question, I poked the policy about you to the superintendent, because Gary didn't find anything regarding this. We were looking at policies today, and that's why I happened to read the one about the consent agenda. If we want to make it a policy, we sure can, but you're going to be possibly inundated with questions, and then these meetings could get a lot longer.
If you would allow me to be inundated, I would put them on a priority list, and I guarantee you I would take care of them.
Well, it would just not be me, though, Bob. It's anyone who has a question would have to go through you with it then. And that would be something that the whole board would approve.
I understand that, but at the same time, I think if we fielded questions from everyone, you'd have a disproportionate amount of them that you're asking relative to everyone else. And you know, I would take them sequentially, like the staff development thing. I think that could have been handled whenever we talk about staff D. It isn't right now, but it seemed to have occupied time and taken an hour out of admin's time this morning.
Well, and per Beth, what did you say before you came into the meeting? That was even a question you didn't know the answer to. And had to go to the MSBA for.
That is true. I did call.
So, call it a bad question. The administration said it was a good question to ask. MSBA says there are no bad questions.
I think this is starting to put me in a bad spot. I am not quite sure what you want me to do. You know, I don't know if I should I know I can't respond to all. I think what we should do is just continue to add things to the agenda. I think that would be a really good way to do it.
Sure.
That way, when it's added, I can do the research and have materials ready for you. It makes everything really open to everyone. But I think that was your suggestion, wasn't it, Bob? To just pre-add it to a board agenda. That way it's legitimately out there, you know. And just so you know, Bob does make the, as chairman, he does make the final say on the board agenda. That mm-hmm. is, you know, Lori and I put it together. You know, we add things that we think are important. I go to admin. You know, Tim or Derek might have something that we add. Jake has added things before. But the final say really is Bob and what he wants to do with that. That is part of his job duties. So
I hope if I have questions at a meeting because I didn't get to ask them before, that you'll respect my irrigation system. I'm not prepared at all to vote on that. I had no idea. Two board members are fully unprepared to vote, and I understand it's a majority, but that's where the being prepared to a meeting, it makes the huge difference. That's $55,000 expenditure. I would have liked to have known more than the 5 minutes or less before the vote what it was. So I'm hoping we get a little leeway. If there's a question that we didn't ask before and it gets to the agenda and we're ready to vote, if we say, we have no idea what you're talking about, can we postpone this for a meeting? You'll understand more.
I will respect that if you two will respect the conversation about things as innocuous as we have on the consent agenda. Maybe that's the wrong word, but the consent agenda is there because we can vote on several items with one motion, our least controversial items and such. So I think that's fair for you not to send the staff out in a direction before this is discussed. It's different than irrigation, I'll give you that for sure. So,
okay.
All right, thank you for the conversation.
I'll make a motion to approve the resolution to accept gifts of District 252.
No second.
Motion by Kurt, motion by Rob, seconded by Kurt. Any other discussion? Resolution time. It's back a ways. I just
page 13.
Page 13. Oh. We haven't usually heard that as a resolution. For acceptance of donations?
Is it a resolution?
We haven't done it before.
We have not been doing it that way.
Sure, we haven't. All in favor of the resolution for the acceptance of gifts, say aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? We're carried. No items under old business. Under new business, consideration to approve the 16-17 winter assistance. Jake.
Yeah, a couple of new names on there, and a lot of old faces as well. So, looking for one girls basketball coach yet.
Looking for a seventh grade girls basketball position. We got a couple of people that we're still talking to. Good to see that we'll have three assistants in girls basketball this year. So numbers are looking good.
Can you comment on the numbers just a little bit?
Well, we had an informational meeting with our new head coach. We invited anybody who's got interest in girls basketball to come to it. And we had 12 high school girls express interest, which would be more than we had out last year. And more than we were expecting, and then 28 seventh and eighth graders so far. So, looking really good so far. Really happy with where those numbers are looking.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Any other questions for Jake?
I'll make a motion to approve the winter assistant coaches.
Motion by Jerry. Second.
I'll second. Go ahead, Brendan.
I'll second.
Thank you, Brendan. Other discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Carry. Consideration to approve the 16-17 seniority list. Beth.
This is just extremely procedural. Every year we need to approve the teacher seniority list. If you have any direct questions on it, I can certainly answer that. You'll see some of the new hires already have tenure in another district, so it gives you the tenure date is also listed behind it.
I'll make a motion to approve the seniority list.
Okay.
Motion by Brenda, seconded by Kurt. Other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. Discussion. Update on the mosquito auction coming up shortly.
Yeah, we had a meeting all day in Rochester on Thursday, but on my way back, bring a change of clothes and go to the auction. We had an unbelievable open house. Very surprised. If I was to guess the number of people, I wish we would have had a sign in, you know, close to 80, 90 people out there. Definitely parking was an issue. We're parking on the road. Lots and lots of interest. So we're excited about that. We did have a box of like masks out because of the mold. So, you know, some people it doesn't bother. Other people, it's kind of a big deal. So I'm pretty excited. I'm not sure if any of you made it out. It was kind of meeting and greeting, and then I left at the end. But it really well received. If nothing else, people are just curious about it. And I think that's good, you know, that word of mouth. It's been a learning curve for me. I have dealt with septics and wells now. I know a lot about them. And Rob's laughing because realtors know these things, and I just simply should never be a realtor. Lots of questions about the tank that was removed and why it was removed. And now they want soil samples for that area. But again, we're selling it as is. People not real concerned about the roof. We disclose everything, you know, ahead of time. It's just a lot of interesting questions. We've been dealing with a lady, Pam Holt is her name, from Goodhue County. She's been helping us with the septic. You know, there's different regulations with mound systems and regular septics, and the location of this one is kind of different because it's actually up by the gravel road. You know, a lot of questions on the, it's zoned agricultural with use of public, and that's a very unique, I guess, one and the only in the state that zoned the exact way ours is. So lots of questions on that. So we just hope the auction goes really well on Thursday. I can't have all of you there, but I think, Kurt, were you planning on stopping out? So we'll have one rep there. I think we've got a really good plan. I'm really excited. Working with Todd Houghton has been really well, just great. He's really done some nice things. He put a nice sign out front. I think the advertisement was good, you know. Had a couple errors in it the first time, so we had to quick change some of those. But, yeah, I've been really pleased. So if you have any exact questions, I can answer those. But I just wanted you to know Thursday will be the last day, and we'll be telling Josh to turn off the electric out there. So,
So they wore masks, but they didn't wear hard hats up here.
No.
Nothing falling down right
nothing,
now.
Nothing coming down.
I thought that that roof had more major issues when we were talking.
I've been up on that roof.
You walked it?
I have too.
It holds me. It's pretty good. I was up there during a rainy season where we were getting 3 inches a week, and the inside was still dry. So it has to be certain rains that will bring in the mold.
And it is kind of a side rain.
Like from the west?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And that's what they said every time. It's kind of a kind of an interesting way that the water actually gets in. So.
The nice thing is you get a lot of hard surfaces like the concrete, so it'll be easier to clean.
Yep.
You have a lot of wood.
Yeah, it really wasn't a concern. People that knew what they were doing were pretty excited about the opportunity. So open house, if that shows any interest, we'll do well. We'll see how it all goes. I plan to send out an email to you immediately that evening with some sort of update. So you guys all know what we do.
I might be there if my client's there.
I still think we're okay. Lori, if we have two board members, I'm okay there, right? Because we have five total. So that makes sense for you to be there.
Kurt, Were you pretty committed to that?
Not necessarily. No, I don't have to be. I mean, it's just...
No, not so much that as being there. I think it's important.
If you want me, I'll certainly be there.
Because that's... I think it's good that Beth doesn't totally carry the stress of making decisions there, and if she had somebody to bounce it off of as well. You're good?
Yep.
Any other discussion?
Thanks for caring about my stress level.
You know, you did set some parameters, but you get close and you don't know if you should
make
that decision.
Right.
Informational meetings. Next regular board meeting is the 14th. By then, the elections will be over. Canvass the elections results for ourselves, the board. And strategic plan review. Beth will be in charge of that. Board members, if you have anything, Rob, let's attempt to get at least two of those three on there.
Well, actually, you kind of talked about one tonight. I mean, integrity and Schedule C was addressed, so we can take that off anyway.
I guess if anything, maybe the staff development is the only thing.
Yeah, in donations, we already are adding what it's for. So really, it's just staff development funds.
Whatever we need, just we'll put around. We'll have some discussion on it.
Great. I don't want to open the can of worms, but I just have a suggestion possibly. One solution to avoid delays by waiting until the board meeting to discuss or bring questions might be to submit questions. If you see something on the agenda, submit the questions, but we don't look for the answers until they can be brought to the meeting and discussed at the meeting.
That's kind of what
so you can submit your questions ahead of the meeting and get them answered at the meeting, rather than just having them answered privately and the rest of us don't hear that or even see those emails.
She said it better. That's what I meant, is if we can get the questions.
So we're not, there are delays by waiting until the meeting to even bring up the questions, and then we have to wait for the next meeting to get the answers.
And it might be the next meeting, if the answers aren't that fast. Again, I don't put a time frame on it. I just ask the question. But I ask because
that's
it's on the agenda.
That's more efficient, I think. That way,
Yeah. And Beth and I talked, and I will only ask questions that she'll bring to the board, you know, so.
Yeah. It just makes me more comfortable.
Yeah. You know, if we got rid of some coaches, whatever. Yeah.
You're right. We have already asked questions, but it would be more efficient to bring it, bring the answers to the board.
Mm-hmm.
I got that, Bob.
You were always so good. Okay, anything else for the cause?
If not, did you hear back from Fliscott about National FFA Convention?
Haven't heard a word.
Ran the semifinals, and so she got a silver. She's one of the top eight in the nation.
Oh, that's fabulous.
Speaking in FFA.
How many attendees? This used to be a Kansas City.
There are 63,000 attendees, and there was an exempt speaker from, it was supposed to be every state, but I think one of them wasn't able to come. So were there 50 of them on the site?
That's fabulous.
I hope she speaks to that, then we can pat her on the back next meeting. Anything else?
Good job.
I would look for a motion to adjourn. Motion by Kurt. Seconded by Jerry. Other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? That is carried. We are finished.
Sure.